Hello, anatomy colleagues. This is Dr. Alsup, and in this video, we will be discussing the muscles we need to identify in the shoulder, brachial plexus, and arm session. In the shoulder region, the most superficial and largest muscle is the deltoid muscle, which I think of as a cap on the shoulder. This is a very coarsely fibered muscle and is a very dominant structure in both an anterior, like we can see here, and a posterior view. So both of these are the deltoid muscle. This is an anterior view. This is a posterior view. It starts off wider, and then it begins to taper off distally into almost a point. Actually, I would make it go down a little bit further. There we go. And it will distally attach on the humerus a little bit above midshaft region. Deep to the deltoid and also in the shoulder region are the rotator cuff muscles. There are three posteriorly located rotator cuff muscles and one that is anteriorly placed, and we will discuss the posterior one first. And note that these three muscles, all three of these, will have a distal attachment on the greater tubercle, which is right here, of the humerus. When trying to identify these rotator cuff muscles on the posterior region, I first locate the spine of the scapula, which is this right here, this bony portion right here. Recall that spine will continue on and it will widen, and that's the acromion that we hopefully are getting familiar with. And so knowing where that spine of the scapula is can help you differentiate the muscles. The supraspinatus muscle, belly, will be located superior to the scapular spine. That's where it gets its name, supraspinatus. Whereas the infraspinatus will be inferior to the spine. See the supraspinatus tendon. So here's the muscle belly. This whole thing right here is muscle belly. It will continue and it will travel deep to the coracoacromial arch right here in order to reach the greater tubercle. And so that relationship right there in terms of that tendon being close to the bone can play a role in terms of some of the breakdown or damage to the tendon that can occur. The teres minor muscle tends to be the smallest of the rotator cuff muscles, and it's located just inferior to the infraspinatus. Sometimes it's really difficult to differentiate between the infraspinatus and the teres minor. It often looks like one big muscle, but it's going to be just inferior to the infraspinatus. Now, also in this posterior region is the thick teres major muscle. Major meaning it is notably larger than the teres minor. The teres major is located between the teres minor and the latissimus dorsi muscle that we dissected way, way back when we were dissecting the back region. Note, the teres major is not a rotator cuff muscle. Its tendon does not form part of the cuff that surrounds the shoulder joint, but it will move the shoulder joint when it contracts. So it will play some role in terms of movement of the shoulder joint. The anterior rotator cuff muscle is the subscapularis, which you can see kind of deep in this region, deep to the subclavian and the axillary artery right here. Its belly covers the anterior side of the scapula, and of course its distal tendon will form part of the rotator cuff that's surrounding the shoulder joint. You can see that around this region here, it's difficult to differentiate between what is tendon and what is capsule here. Moving now to the arm, as we discussed in the last session, there's an anterior and a posterior compartment of the arm. When looking at a superficial dissection, which is what we have here of the anterior compartment, the most prominent muscle is the biceps brachii. The most distinguishable thing with the biceps brachii is that the proximal portion has two heads or two proximal tendons. You can see these are the tendons right here. Here's one. That's your short head. This is your long head. You don't have to differentiate between the two heads, but just for fun. And they will come together to share a common belly and have a common distal attachment. You can really see that short head of the biceps brachii attaching to the deep coracoid process, which is right underneath there. The long head is deeper, so you see that it looks like it kind of is hidden underneath the deltoid muscle. It actually will have a portion of its tendon that travels within the joint cavity of the glenohumeral or shoulder joint. In order to see the other two muscles of the anterior compartment, you need to reflect or remove the biceps brachii muscle, which has been done in this dissection. This is a deeper dissection here. And you can see the two tendons of the biceps brachii, which have been cut. The coraco or coraco brachialis muscle is more superiorly placed, and it's going to be shorter as well. So this is the coraco brachialis. I like to say coraco, but you definitely will hear coraco brachialis. A distinguishing thing regarding this muscle is that the musculocutaneous nerve, which I'm underlining right here, will actually pierce the coraco brachialis, and it's the musculocutaneous nerve that is the dominant supply to this compartment, this anterior compartment. The brachialis, which I'm outlining right now, with a few arteries that are getting wrapped up in there. So this is the brachialis. It begins around, its proximal attachment is around mid-shaft of the humerus and has a very similar belly shape to what we have had with the biceps brachii. So key here is that the brachialis is deep to the biceps brachii. So if you can see the coraco brachialis, generally that means that you're deep, and so brachialis is going to be on that same plane. The posterior compartment of the arm is a bit easier as there is one main muscle here, which is the dominant and large triceps brachii muscle. When looking at a superficial dissection, which is on this side, so this is superficial, you can only see two of the three heads of the triceps. You can see the long head, and you can see the lateral head here. You can see, and they kind of come together and they have this common tendon that's going to attach to the olecranon of the ulna. You need to do a deeper dissection, which has been done on this side. You can see the deltoid's been removed. You can see some of the lateral, the long head of the triceps has been removed as well in order to see the medial head, which is going to be more deeply placed. All right, most excellent. Thank you for your time and attention here, and hope you are starting to get familiar with the muscles in this region. Please reach out if you have any questions.